And Rick Minderman from Corti Brothers is here this
morning.
To give us his crab dad cake. What's a crab?
Well, you must crab like dad, because those are the biggest crab cakes I think I've ever seen in my life.
I've been very fortunate. For the last 5 years, I spent some time in Washington, D.C., going to food and wine festivals. And at Corti Brothers, we get to play around a lot. Uh-huh. A fishmonger, Bill Dawson, who owns seafood suppliers in the Bay Area, has brought us something called peaky toe crab. It's Atlantic rock crab. It is half to two-thirds less expensive than Dungeness, but it's the cousin to Dungeness.
Does it taste similar?
It tastes very, very similar to Dungeness. So you can make a crab cake inexpensively. We also see a lot of crayfish or crawdad tail meat.
Right.
Mini lobsters, freshwater lobsters. So I thought, you know what, we need to sell, we need to make people aware of this peaky toe. It's a bycatch of the lobster industry. Huh. The lobstermen throw them back or break them up and throw them back to attract more lobsters.
Wow. Bill Dawson, you don't want to throw away anything.
You don't want to throw away anything, especially when it tastes so good. So what I've done is I've created a crab cake, which we are selling like this at Corti Brothers. We're going to do sandwiches. You can just buy them. They're $2.99 each, and you just take
them
home and saute them.
Show us how you made them. What's in there?
Let me show. You can do them appetizer size. These, you know, it's cooking season. I take two scoops for a larger size crab cake.
And what's actually in the mixture?
The mixture is just 8 ounces of the crawdad, 8 ounces of the peaky toe crab meat, some celery, some green onion, mayonnaise, and egg as a binder, white pepper, garlic powder, a little salt.
A long list.
And the secret ingredient, pimenton, which is a hundred.
Spanish, right?
It's Spanish.
Yeah.
It's what Columbus brought from the New World to Isabella.
Is it like paprika?
Pepper. It's like paprika, but okay. I think about 100 years before the Hungarians
it's
did.
It's great, though, because you could put it on almost anything, including red meat.
Exactly. It's an amazing spice. What it does to the crab cake is it's more in the finish. You get the flavor, but in the finish, you don't get that fishy finish taste.
Huh.
Now, what I've done here is I'm using panko, and I'm taking the ball, and I'm actually pressing the panko into the mix, and panko is wonderful for breading everything.
And like a Japanese breadcrumb, right?
It's Japanese breadcrumbs. It's very light, airy Japanese breadcrumbs.
So kind of like what you would see with tempura.
Exactly. So what that does, it makes a firm cake. You'll put these in the refrigerator for about a half an hour, and then you'll just fry them. And I use the Sierrana light, fruity arbequina oil, which is perfect. I do all my cutlets in that. It just makes for a wonderful flavor.
Not too heavy.
These things are absolutely delicious. We're developing a crab cake sandwich, avocado, and a little bit of lemon pepper mayonnaise.
It's good to be you, Rick.
Well, you know what? It is fun. I'm very fortunate. I get to play. I get to taste all these wonderful things at Corti's.
And how much is the crab, just before we let you go?
The crab is $15.99 a pound. The crawdad tail meat is $15.99 a pound.
All right.
You can buy the ingredients and make these for about a little over $2 a crab cake. So
good
they're
deal.
Inexpensive.
Hey,
we've got to
run more ideas.
You guys got to taste.
We will be right back.